All right. Some of them, just like I will be explaining you now, of course, right now we get a special guest where get for talk to with today exclusively. Of course, this now posting way not new as far as the Sierra Leone politics is concerned and as far as development in Sierra Leone concerned. This is not somebody where they stand up to the incumbent government, you know, the incumbent political party in Sierra Leone, the All People's Congress. And of course, I know they talk about any other person, and they talk about somebody where you're familiar with. And then Mr. Mohamed Kamarainba Mansaray, again for talk to with today from Maryland in the United States. Of course, Asidena also on a visit. You know, seen a man as Sierra Leone a day, and so he didn't have for visit with. So now an opportunity for let we go able for talk to a brother like this, where possibly go be with next president na Sierra Leone. Hello, Mr. Mansaray. How are you doing, sir?
Thank you. I did do very well. I'm so happy and excited for that day today. And like I said, a very, very season greetings to all listeners and viewers and compliments of the season.
Right. And so we very much delighted as usual. Anytime we bring you come for talk to you, we are very much delighted. Of course, we know say you just come out Salon, Cam, so we know I'm for Western for talk to you exclusively about Sierra Leone. And so, waiting at the state of affairs in the country, like how you left them, waiting at the message where you go able for give about Sierra Leone?
Thank you again. And the message in Sierra Leone right now, especially with I left the country, Salon, the bleed. Salon, down the country where the majority of Sierra Leoneans are not can afford, even waiting for eating in the morning. They're not able to afford for taking them picking to a better school in the country. The cost of living is so high. I left the dollar now is almost close to 800,000 leones per $100. It's 8,000 leones per $1. That's how bad the bag of rice. It's about 250,000 leones. The fuel now per liter is about 6,000 leones. The unemployment rate, the people will not get work, that's alone. They're over 80% of Sierra Leoneans are not get work in the country. This is how pathetic, this is how bad, this is how miserable this current APC government, after 9 years of President Ernest Bai Koroma in governance, now this you don't left the country and the people them. You know, it saddened me when you see all over the country where they go villages them, where they go towns, where they go chiefdoms, where they go now the cities them. The people that all they can say is, we just want to get food now plate. We just want to be able to feed with picking them. We just want to go somewhere to sleep. So the most basic things then, where you say the most basic food and shelter, who said for sleep and waiting for eat, the average majority Sierra Leoneans are not getting. And there's no prosperity, there's no better life if you not champion those two things. Who said motor man they sleep because it get good health, mosquitoes them, and the rain season will come, not to leak, and all them diseases there, and good food. So those are the two major things the way this government and the past SFPP government don't fail the people them of this country. So if you ask me, just in a snapshot, about what in the current affairs, Sierra Leone, they bleed, they bleed, and they bleed.
Wow. You know, very recently, we talked to the Minister of Tourism and Cultural Affairs, Mr. Sidia Tunis. He paints a completely different picture. From waiting, you don't tell we. You tell we say the austerity measures they've been introduced some because it been necessary, because the government not be able to afford the subsidy anymore for fuel, and so that the people are getting along well, that people that they travel around, that it not hit them very, very too much, like how you don't explain. And so I want to focus on the area of transportation. We don't really say problem don't come now, you know, especially with transportation, wherein the transportation costs don't go high, and that drivers, they not get change for give passengers them because they don't put the transportation cost to 2,000 leones or even more. So when passengers, they don't pay this, once they don't count on, the driver not get change for give them, they run with Imotuka. So I want for let you tell we if how the ordinary civilian, they actually handle this issue of austerity measures na Salon.
This austerity measures na sham. From what I mean sham, na just a fake way for fool the people of this country. Mm-hmm. And also for really pacify the international community for say the APC government to do something.
Mm-hmm.
9 years in governance. This is not to today. In fact, if you for being get some of the recording where I don't do with you,
mm-hmm.
you interviews them before, mm-hmm. you go see years ago, 3 years ago.
Right.
Me myself, a leader and chairman of mm-hmm. the Alliance Democratic Party,
mm-hmm.
a presidential candidate for
2018, mm-hmm.
I call on the president and this APC government, say then they misuse your economy, the corruption so blatant, and the country they can go down because Sierra Leone, we economy, where we get we all money in the country. This government, over 60% of we money in the country,
mm-hmm.
then just they pay themselves salary, mm-hmm. bonuses, and you know, benefits, buy mutkadem, then $80,000 land cruisers them for the guy.
Mm-hmm.
No country not to survive
mm-hmm.
and be a better country when you spend 80% of your income, over 60% of your income just for pay yourself. So what's left
mm-hmm.
now about 35% or so, and then go for pay the, because this president don't lend over $6 billion from 9 years ago maybe. So we go for pay then debt then they. And then money not go for left for make this country. It don't even, maybe don't call on this president since 2013 to 14, before even the Bola come. Now say this country here, it go down, and this president, in motorcade when I motorcade alone, it get over 20 motorcade or more to 30 waking pass go up and down, where they go walk or go up and down, where the whole country, the ambulance they open get, now about 6 or 7 ambulances them, before the Bola come.
Right.
How a country, you motorcade, you and the vice president, when I get over 20 to 30 motorcade, Land Cruisers, 80,000 motorcade, they go up and down, Mercedes-Benz them, when the whole country, the ambulance is about 7. So you don't see what we don't talk, say, this country need austerities or whatever you want to call it now, but 1 year to when the one left, now the 10 and one can fool the people and now say, oh, well, they can't do austerity measures. No. This was 5 years ago, 7 years ago, 3 years ago, 6 years ago, we get the same problem where they go on at the country. It just not happen just all of a sudden. In fact, we think how they in there, when the president in September or so, it came with over 50 entourage. In Aminaya, we say they spend over $1 million. It charge a one old plane. We can sit down in New York for a couple of days for wait for until where the convention done. Or, and I return back with the plane. So those are the kind of things where we've been call on this president and the government, say that they misuse we country, we economy, and that make now not too long, then go begin to say, oh, we cut down on travels, we do this. This, like I tell you, this is all baloney. This is all a way where they want to fool the people of this country. But we mean the voice of the voiceless in that mm-hmm. country, I can always come for tell people in the truth. So this austerity measures, like where you act, so it's not just, it's just a drama, then just the act. What in this APC good at?
Mm-hmm.
Now for act. Right now you see the ministers and they travel, they wear t-shirt them for take pictures and send them on social media, then they go do this, and then just the act, then just the launch. What in the launch? 9 years, we know they see nothing. You go over and say, oh, the youth program, they can't launch a youth village. There's no youth village. Where they can't launch this. There's nothing. Then just the fool people them, and then rhetorics weigh on so much. And I tell you, enough is enough. The people of this country, they don't tire, and no amount of foolery, no amount of technique for come act go work again. So like I say, the country don't get sense. The people is smarter, and come 2018, then go make a better choice for remove the APC and put ADP, the Kamarainba State House.
And so, Mr. Mansaray, you know, all can talk to APC government officials, including the presidential spokesman, you know, the ministers in government, the secretary general of the party. You know, they can always say, we say, you know, other countries there around the world don't introduce austerity measures because then look at and say unnecessary for a country. But then when we look at some other countries, then where they introduce austerity measures, would they see then leadership, they take responsible actions then for able for proof to the citizens then for say they mean them by either riding transportation, I mean passenger transportation, flying, you know, passenger planes and stuff like that. From your observation at the country, you don't see anything like this on the part of the government operatives for say, then they do things the way the lay Sierra Leonean go look at and talk, say, you know what, see, them man, they are then set up the suffer just like how would they suffer. Then they take the austerity measures seriously.
Absolutely not. My brother, this, like I say, the austerity in a provocative term, and then come for just fool the people of this country. They're not taken serious, like you are breaking news.
Mm-hmm.
I just, this morning, I received a copy of an invitation where they go on today, na McKinney,
mm-hmm.
where the APC Secretary General,
mm-hmm.
In courtesy of the President, and it's by Koroma,
mm-hmm.
then they launch a fundraising. Guess how much they charge for just can inside a hall? Mm-hmm. Now $1,000. This is not the minute, 5 million leones.
Mm-hmm.
5 million leones per person for just can inside and see them one raise money for go build the $2 million office with a different plan for Bill na McKinney.
Mm-hmm.
This is just a breaking news to you now.
Wow.
It then get her now, like I tell you, the president tonight, then they are now as we talk na McKinney, where every minister, deputy minister, honorables, and directors, commissioners, them, they mm-hmm. all go for go pay that five million leones. And the Secretary General did state, say five million leones for entrance. So if these people are more serious, how then go tax ministers, deputy, whatever, 5 million leones, when are close to almost $1,000, just for go say that they raise funds to themselves? Then I want, let's come back to another thing, them, we see how this government, they use loose words just for fool the people, like austerities.
Mm-hmm.
Like you say, then the president still, they continue in convoy, the VP, then they go up and down, then they just don't hire another youth aide not in office because he pulled by Mahmoud, when I be the presidential youth aide, they make a minister of youth, and not too long ago, after the austerity measures, he appoints another one at that position, they just know no more now. There's a lot of things that will not change at all. Like I say, they see ministers, them, I just see ministers, they participate, they go Saudi Arabia, they take pictures, them, you they see, you know, then just they do things that will not ever change. You
right.
know, like I tell you, those are the kind of things, them, where you they see where this country, this president, then just they lose those words for fully pull them. The people already suffer now, the ordinary Sierra Leoneans and at the street. We're not getting for eat. We're not get transportation means for go one side because, like how you talk, so we said they be pay 1,000 or 2,000 leones. And then, like how you say, it's just so much
mm-hmm.
to a point that way. Right now, the people are hopeless. And right now, the people are just the wait for savior. At the return back the 7th of January, na Freetown, people can't wait for can't receive me all over the country. For me, they can't receive me from Ferry Junction. That by up gone under, they go with me all the way to my office, na 30 Road Street. The people and just they call, they send me messages, them, they don't tire, and they don't tire because this APC government don't completely fail them, and they not get hope with the SAPP government, because right now SAPP just they fight their own shadow, they not get direction, they not get leadership, they not even get a focus. So because of that, the only right now presidential candidate now the old country now me winner Mohamed Kamarainba Mansaray. So that show how serious the Alliance Democratic Party be. That show you how serious me Kamarainba for ready for take this country, because no other political party will they look at 1 year to election, because the election they get in February of 2018. No presidential candidate, not in any 11 political party, but Mohamed Kamarainba Mansaray. This just show, indeed, God willing, come 2018, I will be the next president as well.
Right. We let you optimism, Mr. Mansaray. And so we get for can't talk about your candidacy exclusively per this interview. But let me deal with the national government first. You know, would they look at one of the areas that where the APC government don't dwell on so much for the past 9 years, where they always tell people that, in fact, Ayeriwe, one a musical artist, Emma Sing, where they sing, they talk, say, any question where you ask the government and say, you know, see what make road, you know, see what make road. So this road construction are one of the areas that where they don't dwell so much that, now one of the things that where they don't do, that they don't ignore all other areas. And when we look at other than the Magdalen roads here for Sierra Leone under the APC government, now China. And most of the Chinese stuff that what they see, not to things that were durable, not to things that way they last. So based on the fact that you they travel right around the country, they travel now them roads, then the way they see them roads then, I don't say you not to engineer. But you feel saying that roads then we get for last in Sierra Leone, thinking about the fact that we not get the capacity for maintain things the way a government they put in place for we. You feel say then roads there and that things that we get for last.
Absolutely not. My brother, make I just draw you back. Mm-hmm. Make Sierra Leone and they know. Waiting this APC government do a loophole, then can't find about fixing roads. Mm-hmm. Because the international community ready for give loans mm-hmm. for make roads.
Right.
So waiting and do from 2013, where President Ernest Bai Koroma been sacked, according to Ram, corrupt Almami Pepito Koroma. Mm-hmm. He said for corruption, he sacked him, the Minister of Works. Mm-hmm. When he sacked that minister there, from 2013 to recently, which is about a few months ago, you right. know, even 1 year yet, mm-hmm. where the president now be run the ministry, kind of. The State House will run the ministry. So there's no minister. So what happened, every contract where be the common other ministries there, mm-hmm. It will go through State House. In fact, where it include somebody for make a cancer of another ministry, and in one of him best body, where you will know the whole country know about cocaine saga and corruption, where Kemosi say, mm-hmm. now you don't go get that ministry there. So in nine best body, I mean the best of friends. Way anything we can all see and it's chromati see. So now you don't go get. That's clearly show what you then do, then road there away you see then the fix. We then go take them loan. I'll give you one example. Mm-hmm. One roadway from Hillcourt Road down, it's less than about 3 miles or so. Mm-hmm. Now the most expensive road now the whole world. Quote me on this. Mm-hmm. No road no day now the world, even including America. Mm-hmm. Way expensive reach that road day. The Minister of Finance in SSF openly say this road now the most expensive road now the whole world. This road been cost about I think 4 million or so for fix about less than 2 mile road. You're not gonna believe my brother, this is how much contract then they give because they get cutbacks, mm-hmm. then get everything where they give. That's not one force. You come to this Chinese where they give majority. Look one road where they don't go give, we don't pay for this road already. The mm-hmm. road now from Wellington to Masheka. Mm-hmm. We don't pay them. The country, the people don't pay for the road. Now, what did this government do, including the parliamentarians there now, mm-hmm. then go give Chinese this contract, say, now $50-something million. They say, okay, when I can't make this road 4 lane instead of 2 lane, when I can't add another lane, it can be a toll lane. So we're not going to charge about $100 for each big truck mm-hmm. when they pass there.
Right.
20,000 for Mutkadem. So imagine, possibly we can buy rest, you get for pay 500,000 for cross. Mm-hmm. That rest way for being cost 200,000. They go make 220,000. What are they suffering at the people? And I be don't go na radio I talk say, you not get no right as a government for force people into a toll road, we not get an alternative road. What did this government for don't do? That $154 million road day, then for go build new road, then left that already roadway we don't pay for. This mm-hmm. road we don't pay for them. From the early 90s. So we don't need for can Adam force people and for pay toll. And I don't tell them, say, me on presidency, no Sierra Leone are not going to pay that. And that loan where they don't sign so, in very illegitimate, a very wrong, and we are not go as president, condone them. When I mean they sign on a parliament, I go to the air, I talk them over and over, I say that loan day is wrong, and we Sierra Leone are not for afford that. I remember a senior APC minister by then, he called me. He mm-hmm. said, Kamarainba, you're right, because, you know, we're not supposed for the first people, even America, what we get with toll roads, them, and the minister, what he even quote, he said, and they give alternative roads, them. you not go force because you go pay where you want, go a place where you not get traffic. You go pay that money, they forget that toll day. So then a second, the third instance I'll tell you about this infrastructure road where they claim about. If you look at right now, most of them, even at the provinces them, where they go do them small street loan and now pure cutbacks them and now pure debt them, where we don't take from all over, where they take away over 50 or 60 or 70 years for pay. And they're not explaining the Sierra Leoneans and that, you know, and then just they go ahead and do them things there. So, like you tell me, so the Sierra Leonean in general, I'll tell you this, Sierra Leone, the Sierra Leoneans, they don't turn to third-class citizen, not the country. All the developments the way they go on, them big companies there now, you see even the banks there in Nigerian, they own them, Lebanese own them, India man they own them, now na Chinese don't take over now. You're not going to believe this, when you go, Ibrahim, na Sierra Leone, you go really know, say, we Sierra Leoneans them, we don't left back, we don't be third class. You see Wilkinson Road, you go about in all them big mansions, the hotel, na foreigners that own them. Sierra Leoneans them, they don't push them backward. You go to a bank, you want to take loan, you go to be for business, they know they give you. You go now certain things, they know they encourage you. Everything from Zenith Bank, FI Bank, all the major banks in Asalon, they're owned by Nigerians. And we Sierra Leoneans them will not able. In fact, the president, one of the oldest Salon government bank who get in a Rukel, they don't put them to privatization, and they want put them, late person can buy them. They're not even able to sell them up to now. Like I tell you, this country bankrupt, and that they use this road for fooling people. I remember vividly where some Sierra Leoneans and say, Kamarainba, no worry, not to road will they eat. We don't see the road, but not to will they eat. What will they eat? We'll not get, when I say development, it starts with your belly, your stomach. Now, this is how they tell people, there's no better roads where somebody they're hungry. So there's no better roads where somebody not get good medicine, where sick. There's no better road where somebody not even get a bicycle for ride there. So like I say, that road they are now, today your ministers, the way they get a big mutka them, and then they left them, the people and they suffer because they not even get waiting for it.
And so, yes, Mr. Mansaray, recently we see the president make a triumphant return from China. After we make a state visit there, you know, he come back, he say he don't bring plenty development programs then from China. Some of we, they look at the facts, say, you know, since 2007 to 2016, we country for don't embark on capacity building, wherein they for not able for focus on the youth then, when are the leaders of that country tomorrow, for able for building capacity so that we country not get for the go and big around, any smarty way happen pass will go big, any smarty way happen pass will go big. Now, I want for let you go give me an idea about what you think about the president in visit na China, recently we go China.
What I think that the same what this president will do for the past 9 years, including the past president, Ahmed Tshijankaba. Then just believe, say, now the international communities, now then forgive me, like we say, we go bigger. I remember vividly the information minister talk, say, we go for go bigger. Use the word bigger. So, he go on to China, I say, then go negotiate weapons. I say, then go for go more bag. You're not going to believe this, not only for bag for the country and for go there. Then they go big for the APC party. And they tell you this back in other breaking news.
Right.
The Chinese government or so, whatever Chinese companies them. Mm-hmm. Then now that they come build about about $5 million building. Now I'm center of Freetown, a high rise building, a 12-story building for the APC party. Can you imagine?
Wow.
This is, I can give you a breaking news. I feel so happy. They don't go get a contract. We're very soon. They can build a 12 or 15 story building just for the APC party.
But we'll be here, you say that building, not they no, we'll be here, you say.
That they can below.
We'll be here,
go negotiate for university. Then go negotiate for can build, then call them an APC party house. Where na then you the party get them. You know, you come back to, like we call it, don't they give the Chinese them contract upon contract upon contract for make roads, for build us them, because now they're badin, they can build us them for the sell them, for the rent them. So they will now, they say, okay, one do, they not say can't give back now the country, for low build university, low build more schools, low improve their secondary schools there. They're not this, that they say, no, can't spend how many million dollars for they can build 12 or 15 story for we party. Now that the Chinese that they can do. Like I say, you know, me really take on this visit of the president when you see him, a fail way, And I can tell you, then just one go back, they go big, then do no country there, where they not get no idea, because no country, you know, ever see bigger man at tickets gently. When you go big, big, you know, they ever better. You know, so you just watch them. No bigger man, no the big no more. You go below, you go buy a motor car, you put him picking at school, you know, it's travel, you know, go able. So now the same thing, a country where depend just for big, big, they're not going to ever be a country where you go prosper. So like I can tell you, you know, the capacity building right now, we need for create jobs. Sierra Leone, a consuming country. We're not a producing country. Now, Salona see the toothpick where. We don't eat done. You don't tell for clean it eat. Now made in China. The Q-tip where they clean you is. We go buy in a salon at the street. Now made in China. Everything a salon. We not get where we would able to produce, alter and consume what they consume. We they spend $160 million. $160 million for just import rest in a salon. Every year, my brother. Mm-hmm. We agriculture sector is so poor. We not they produce anything. Everything now for order. Now I make you see the dollar, they skyrocket. The president being, when he came 2007, the dollar have been 2,900 leons. Now it's about 8,000 leons in 9 years. So just calculate it. Because we not get nothing. Where would they go sell at international or trade agreement? So instead of what they say, the president going to China for go negotiate trade, say, Salon go can produce this, or Salon, even the iron ore, where they cargo the raw material, instead of cargo the raw material, Sierra Leone go can begin get an add value for bringing the machine them, no can produce the iron ore to iron rod, na Sierra Leone. Mm-hmm. So now this trade agreement to go China, make a cow the machines them, where go can employ 20,000, 10,000, 5,000 Sierra Leonean for produce the iron ore to iron rod. Then not they do that. Then just they go negotiate for big, say, oh, we don't go look Korea for goodness sake. We don't go take $50-something million for can build city council. For you imagine. You know what, see that? $50-something million just for one building. And look and say, oh my goodness, this country don't lost their power. This government don't lost their priority. So in a nutshell, like I tell you on this, you just see where we not they produce and consume. And everyday Sierra Leoneans, as a leader, what do you for the think about right now? Now for empower the private sector. Now for make sure, say, you even some Sierra Leoneans that within their abroad, including Sierra Leone, include them into a national cohesion for say, okay, this is the deal. This is not the money days. What do you now want produce? Now mango juice. Now orange juice, one make sure say where you can a Safeway, you can a Giant, you can a American grocery store, you will buy orange juice, you see and say made in Sierra Leone. But Sierra Leone will not get that. You go see the even the rubber plantation at Calaon, where they go make bicycle tire, where they go make motorcar tire, where they go make Okada tire. Low we see are made in Sierra Leone. But we know they get the Sierra Leone leadership. Mm-hmm. We leaders them, they're not innovative. They don't get no creative way of thinking how we they able to get a capacity building for create jobs. And we need for do that because now these jobs, people ain't going to pay taxes. And with these taxes, now they will be able to get a way where the economy will go say, yes, we get a sustainable and better economy for run. But right now, what the IMF say, now this for do, now enough for do. What the Chinese they say, now this for do, now enough for do. It's sad, it's sad, it's sad. And like I say, come 2018, mm-hmm. enough. We are moving forward, and the people are going to make this change. We go pull this APC in power, and then we'll put ADP in governance.
Right. And so, Mr. Mansaray, it looked like, say, you really get confidence in the 2018 election. Of course, all of us do as Sierra Leoneans. But when we look at the APC government, the way they operate right now, a lot of Sierra Leoneans, that they create doubt in the ability of the APC government for hold a very free, fair and transparent national presidential and parliamentary elections in Sierra Leone, because they don't get any record from 1961 to 2016. They don't get any record for say they don't ever hand over government to a democratically elected government. And so, what do you go tell we about your own belief in the fact that by 2018 Sierra Leoneans will go to the polls and elect a new president?
You know, then can get one parable in a salon where they say 100 day for thief man, mm-hmm. one day for master house. Mm-hmm. My brother, yes, what you talk, the APC, then this talk and boldly say they get 99 way of winning election. So 99 way of winning election, the one way, not the honest way. And 2018 will be the honest way. You know, you go able to reach, look what's happening in Gambia. You go get confidence. You say, I can't win this election. When the people speak, because the people are God in voice. When they say enough, you know, go with thief. I remember when I go do two by election not too long ago, one na McKinney constituency 30. I get about 40% of the vote, just 7 days of campaigning. 7 days, I get 40%. That shows say, even the people say, oh, Kamarainba, now you and ADP, we don't win this, now tip the election. That's when I left them. 100 days for Tiff Man, 1 day for Master House. We cannot lose out. About 30% of the election, 5 days of campaigning, just 5 days. So that show you say, if I able to get 4,000 votes in 7 days in McKinney, about 5,000 votes in 5 days in Lusar, then a 1,000 votes per 1 day, that shows say the people are ready. You know, the people are ready for move, for change. So they don't if they believe in me, come 2018, they make, I still get confidence in neck. We don't try, we don't try for get participation agents them, because now the elections now right there that they count them. As you don't show every polling station that they count, every polling agent sign a paper for sure say they agree to the count, then post the result, then they take them to the center. So we don't really limit certain things the way then go able, because I make one thing I say, they're not going to reach the election much. I could tell you this for fact, because if they be able to reach them, they know they campaign much. The way they go campaign a Losar, and it's by Kuruma, it go na Losar, incessant, with short crosses, it go campaign host to host against me. No sitting president, no go campaign on a by-election. And it's Kuruma don't do them, President Kuruma don't do them to me in Bombali. He go to the chief, that place and that paramount chief, he go there all night, all day, all night, for convince them. And he come back in a Losar the same way. Now the two times I see don't come against Kamarainba. That show say the president himself get fear, the APC get fear. Now this make I say where Kamarainba sneeze, this government they get cold. Now this I be talking on radio. I see if I sneeze then they get cold, because the reason as a sitting president, right, you don't get fit if you don't serve the people well in 9 years. You know go grab you yourself. All the ministers them almost they all can Losar. Now that I been talk during that 10 day I say I don't count with the cabinet and Losar. And they count fish, rice, they count everything for fully people. But just 5 days, my brother, you see the over of almost 5,000 votes we have been getting now that on Saturday. That should say the people are ready for change. And if you watch them on the result, all the surrounding villages, them, now the town, now the constituency, are beat APC flat down. The ADP beat them flat down. You go watch them. The only side where they come, win now inside the Losar town, the township. Now they didn't even win, and that make because now they the majority people in there, but almost all, including the back place of S.I. Kuruma, the former vice president of APC, Losar Ibon, the town we born, I beat APC on a double digits there. So that show you say, you know, the Sierra Leone are ready for change. And I just go spend 20 minutes in that town day. 20 minutes, my brother. I beat APC in that town day. So I have faith. I believe in them, because there's a time where we they make history. There's also a time where history they make way. Now this I can always tell people, with the time where they make history, there's a time where history they make way. And I can, because as a leader, you can forget faith first in the system. Mm-hmm. You can forget faith with the people that we want to go serve. And I get faith in Sierra Leoneans. I'm telling you, as you go serve so much faith to a point, what is you don't alone? I can turn and say, you know what? Trust me, come 2018, the world, the country will go shake, because, you know, we cannot afford for living that kind of poverty here, because, you know, we not for living that kind of poverty here, you know, because God not make we for suffer. Now, this may God give you with 5 senses, he give you eyes, he give you with hands them, he give you food for low strong, he make mortal man, human, so strong, because God no one make we suffer. Now, we leaders, they make people and they suffer. And because of that, I want come back, Lord, we can turn things them around, Lord, make this country a better country.
And so, Mr. Mansaray, by historical evidence, we know say in Sierra Leone, for let anybody win as president of that country, you get forget support not only in two of the regions, the four regions in the country. Let's say like you're able for get massive win now the northwest of the country. If the southeast, they're not able for vote for you, you know they become president of the country. So far, what you go tell we about waiting at your support rate now the southeast of the country?
Thank you. You know, you just, a senior government officer just made a crack joke to me one day. Mm-hmm. Meet up in a plane. Now he say Kamarainba, he say you support now the Northwest. He said the North you get absolute support, mm-hmm. and the Freetown, the West, you get absolute support. He said, what about the North, the South, and the East? Now I laugh. Now I tell him, I say, you have no idea. Now Kono, I grew up, and Kenema. Mm-hmm. You're not gonna believe when you go Kono. Not too long ago, one Abib Jalo just go bury Mama. Mama die Kono. He just come. We meet up in Philadelphia. Now he said, Mr. Kamarainba, he said, I go Kono. He said to me, God, he said, I swear to God, nothing no go make you no win Kono. He say, I'm not Sabio. You. He say, I go. Any side where I go, the ghetto them, the attire base, the fish market there. Any side where I go, they say, Kamarainba, now what do you wait for? He said that they call you the tormentor, the tormentor. Now I say, oh my goodness. He say, so what do people know they believe is, when I go na Kailau, I go Daru. Mm-hmm. I mean, I be the first politician during Ebola. When I go Kailau, I go Daru, Chief Kalong, Bindena Daru, mm-hmm. and the Paramount Chief. He right. give me in Barre. You not go believe. When I come back after the Ebola, the chief tell the people and say, this man, where the Ebola been there? Now he can help we. Now he give we what he need for give we for make a boost. Because now me return a Kalau, go tell President Nkrumah. I say, President Nkrumah, come on now, you ivory towers and state house. Go na Kalau, go outside the Ebola there. Mm-hmm. Now me been go do an Africa at the time.
Right.
So you not going to believe over 200 to 300 in about 4 hours, they can't take membership card na Daru town. Then pay 20,000 leons each. Remember, they don't get money. So people, they go fend the money, they want 1,000, they rap and so, mm-hmm. they call them. For normal men, they can't take membership card. You know, mm-hmm. as you know, I look and I say, can you imagine? 4 hours, I get about 300 people away can't take membership card. You know, it show me, say, who for trust the Sierra Leonean people. Because when they see leadership, mm-hmm. when they see the charisma, mm-hmm. when they see a God sent person, believe in me, Salon people, they will show me support like I talk so now. The South, I go Moyamba, the same thing. Moyamba, when I reach there, the people, everybody been just say, they say, oh no, Kamarainba, we don't hear you so much. You don't lay your life. In fact, one slogan, they say, maybe don't lay me life for the people. And where Jesus Christ, we don't sacrifice. I remember vividly one pastor, we be talking at the meeting. Mm-hmm. He said that that's you, we don't do. Because what you do, even the bosses them, the time we hold this government here, because the government bad. This government ready for the do people and bad. But you ready for lay your life for we. He said, we for pay you back. We for make sure say we pay you. He said, because the SFPP don't fail we, the APC don't fail we. So what do they do now? Will they look for something new? Because let's tell you, IB, you see, this sense where God give we, mm-hmm. now for let we look for change.
Right.
When you follow something over and over and mm-hmm. over, you not see a result, mm-hmm. change. Now right. make God give we sense.
Exactly.
But we Sierra Leoneans, and I think now that they don't do, they don't give APC 10 years all over the country, like how you talk so, Kono, Kenema and Kailau, trust me, you go see waiting to go on there during the election. The South, you come Moyamba, you come Nabo, you come Pujong. In fact, me coordinator on Abo, you just go Pujong, then they say all the youth then at the Pujong town, they say they can't wait for Maker come because I can't go get a big offices them na each district. This go where they go so now, na Moyamba, each district. Would they go get them? Because me don't know, say, this is not a party no more we can for go, now party we can for stay with them. So, me support base on the, honestly, now all over the country. But for now, everybody they go with the flow because now the North, I don't contest election, now the West, the old man they say, Kamarainba, now the Northwest, now they ended the ADP, now they're the stronghold. But believe in me, they'll stronghold now all over the country. And I believe, say, the Southeast, will be a turning point. Make I tell you, because you know they hide me secret, how they win this election.
Mm-hmm.
Though this question I narrow a little bit on that. Though we just, I tell you this, the stronghold at the North and the West, we match APC, divide the vote there. Mm-hmm. Either come first or second or some position, then but also maintain that position and they, well, we don't do them by election, the 40% of the vote, now the whole North, mm-hmm. about 40% or whatever vote, now the West, or 50%. So, and then we can at the Southeast, we get a similar vote than they. We don't go to the, because this election, they go runoff. Make I tell you this now, they predict unto you today, mark my word, on this station, it go runoff. And what do we do right now? We they go runoff with either APC or SFPP. Mark my word on this. Mm-hmm. And if we go runoff with either APC or SFPP, we don't win this election. So we go now and me on goal. Now for now we get this maximum support now the North, mm-hmm. like hold on the show and so now the West and now the South and now the East. So if we're able to do that, believe in me, we don't go runoff with one party there. And then two colonial party, we don't fail the country. If we go runoff, there's no way we're not going to win this election. Now, I don't call on most of the fractures them of the APC we don't so disgruntled that they come join me, and then the SAPP we no go and call big names them, but don't get names that we don't reach out to me, and then just 1 week after the convention they're ready for can't join me for low because they don't see a future, including members of parliament. Now parliament we don't reach out to me, both APC and SAPP we don't ready for can't join me come 2018.
Wow, that very good information where you don't share with me, Mr. Mansaray. And so, Mr. Mansaray, plenty of people that can talk say, you know, you they do these things against the APC. They talk openly, you they criticize them because of, at one point you were a member of the APC, then the kind way the party make you left them. So people that feel say you they revenge at them, the people that feel say the vengeance where you get against them are because of waiting it don't happen between you and the APC operatives them. You know, you go out for tell me if this is not the case or that is the case.
Absolutely not. You know, make I tell you a little history.
Right.
Salon people and they forget quick.
Uh-huh.
Sheka Stevens will form APC.
Uh-huh.
Now drive them with driver at the SAPP.
Right.
He was a former SAPP person.
Mm-hmm.
When he failed for go sign that Declaration of Independence,
mm-hmm.
now that election before independence or dependence something,
mm-hmm.
we come now and drive him.
Mm-hmm.
We then drive him, now he go form the APC.
Mm-hmm.
So imagine. Now history will repeat itself so.
Mm-hmm.
So we now be one we all everybody were born in the 70s.
Mm-hmm.
Now one political party will meet in a salon. Because now APC, we'll not be serving no party.
Right.
Everybody were born in the 70s. All man will be APC. Because mm-hmm. technically now be one party state.
Mm-hmm.
So where we grow up, now one party me know. So why go and go? I say, okay, I go join and I say, well, I can't run under this. If you watch no more,
mm-hmm.
I challenge some APC people. I say, go around, go see if I get any APC shot. Close who I don't wear, or you see me, a whole APC, anything where they go at the palm with, I say, go watch them. You know, they see them. Because I've not been believing the values, but I've been believing some of my times when you go change.
But Mr. Mansaray, you be the wear the red tie, though.
No, the red tie, the red tie, the red green tie, go me face.
Okay.
Down, they see green. I mean, color to me, I'm not too color sensitive. Because then there's a difference, it's a red tie wear.
Okay.
If red fine, because of Christmas season, this, I don't mm-hmm. use for wear red.
Okay.
I'm not too worried. Green, if you see I wear one green gown one day,
mm-hmm.
I go to the market and I work on a Abacha Street. You see the video then on Facebook.
Okay.
Go watch them. To me, those green red is nothing.
Right.
This is the thing we want
exactly,
to change.
Exactly.
The colors
mm-hmm.
and the tribe, for say Timini, Limba, Mende, we are not a Sierra Leone. We are not a Timini Sierra Leone. We're not a Kranko, Mandingo, Fula Sierra Leone. We just one Sierra Leonean.
Right.
And that we for always remember. You know, so I'm not too worried. But if you watch it, like where they see this APC, go old flag and see T-shirt, we get APC, or go watch it. You're not going to ever see me there. Because the problem is, when I come, you know, the similar way where they say, oh, they want to go get a renew me membership card. They say 1.1 million I pay. They say, no, they need you card. That's okay. Then I go sit down, I write ADP. You know, I remember one of me, the deputy chairman now, self,
mm-hmm.
Ibrahim Togo, in America, he sit down with me.
Mm-hmm.
Now he say, leader, he say, what's happening? Now I say, with a form party. He said, no, go first, no, go talk to president. I said, no, I'm not getting no reason for talk to president.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not getting no reason for talk to any APC person.
Mm-hmm.
I say, one thing about life, where God want make you somebody, mm-hmm. it confuse people. Now, so in the Bible, the Quran, it confuse people. So God want make me president. But then two party there, because when you be president,
mm-hmm.
then party are, they don't get something that they call anachronism. They don't get, you know, people can change them. So
mm-hmm.
if we get something new, because me, I worship Sierra Leone. Me 9-year-old girl, Pike, I name Sierra Leone Mansaray. I love this country. So I worship Sierra Leone. After God, na Salon, I worship. So because of that, I'm not going to likely do this. So God wants Lord to do this. I say, Lord, we just form a new party. This is how the ADP forms. So if Sheki will form APC, been the SAPP, then together, he go form 4 years or 5 years, he win. So now the similar thing. So if everybody get an argument, say, if Sheki be disgruntled at the time, revenge. So made them feel like that. But trust me, it's not a revenge. To me, not just God guidance, say, don't be with this party. I want make you president, but I want make you president at the APC. I believe that God been done do, and that this God Almighty is a wonderful God, and I believe in him. And I trust every time I mean wisdom now from God that I get them, and what they ask God every day, I ask and say, I know want money, I know want nothing. Now wisdom, no more want every day, every prayer, every day what they pray, now wisdom I ask for. So and like I say, now that wisdom that God they guide me up to now, where you they see 1 year old party don't contest. Six elections and by election, three parliamentarians and three local council elections. That just show you how serious and how much a national name I don't be in that country, because na God anytime I work na God they guide me. Everybody now they put in the Lapana street where they pass the Maketuma and Abacha street, they put in a street where they pass, you know, then just they no say me no say not to anything, not to money, not to fine, not to sabi talk, not to anything. Now God they guide them people I made and come close to me. You know, I'm so humble and I believe say with God when the way God want make sure, because that country they God let them. We get diamonds, we get iron ore, we get gold, we get about 20 something minerals in that country. But Salona the poorest, one of the poorest countries on earth. It not go be under me watch, it not go be under Kamarainba watch, it not go be under ADP watch, and I go make sure say the Sierra Leonean them go be proud for me to get a leader when they call Mohamed Kamarainba Mansaray come 2018.
And so Mr. Mansaray, the other thing where people that they talk again is that just like how you don't talk, Sierra Leone gets all these natural resources where God don't endow we with. But we still continue to be one of the poorest countries in the world. Some people they talk say the reason we're responsible for this, of course, partly na corruption, partly na the type of leadership the old don't get. But the main reason where they say responsible for this, na the way where Sierra Leoneans and they even disobey God Almighty. They say plenty juju work they go on at Sierra Leone. Plenty ritual murders, the people that they kill, people that they pull them party, they use them for rituals. And so that if you say the next government where they come, at least go get a one ministry, even if now just for 5 years, what they call Ministry of Religion. We're go able for focus the people that again to God in business. Whether they are Muslims on Friday, let all man support. Whether they are Christians on Sunday, all man support. You know, not something like that one day you don't think about at all a YCD you know campaign.
Absolutely. Make I tell you, I get four imams that will come to me and some pastors at one time. In fact, one of the pastors of the party said, and listen to me na radio. He said, you know, one day listen to any politician, we call God. He said, me call God 15 times over the interview. Before you even ask this question, if you go back, I don't call God a lot of time.
Right.
God is an almighty, we got all the power. Any nation will not believe for serve God. Will not believe in the leadership, the direction of God. We know they prosper. So, like I say, I don't think about time, and I assure them at the damn meeting day, I say my presidency, I they get the Ministry of Religious Affairs, where they focus purely on the discussions that we get. So we need, because like I say, the ritual, them look, just yesterday, I see a report where they say they go kill one general, the former general, the head of the army. They go shoot at 3 o'clock in the morning like us. You know, anybody believe God no go and kill another human being? How much more you get at this world, for goodness sake? You they die, you they go meet your maker tomorrow. Why you want to go kill another human being? Why? Why, for goodness sake? For politics? For money? For what? So those are the kind of things, my brother. You see, when you come into God, now that wisdom day, I can ask anybody and can say, come on, remember what you get? I say, now God. I don't get 99 ways of winning election. Now only one way, God Almighty. Now God go for talk to the people of that country today for me to come, support and vote for me. Not to me. You go and talk to you now. Now God will convince you. I remember some questions the way people like, I can go and town hall meeting. Then they say, Mr. Kamarainba, one day convince we. I say, I'm not able to convince you. I can't talk to you. Now God go able to convince you. We go lay down at that pillow. Now God go for talk to you. That's not my statement, because I'm not going able. You know, so my message really, we as nation, for continue for really hold on to God. We are tolerant nation religiously. Lano take away from that. But we need for do more. We get few other people and other factors that when just believe say then go can't lie. If you believe in God, you don't even need for lie to the people. If I say I want to be president, and I can't give free education, both primary and secondary in that country, and I can't give free lunch, every picking they get lunch. That I don't talk in that country. If I be president, I don't do them. God go for God ask me to my one, I don't do them. Because I don't lie give people them. Lie no good. Lie na the root of all evil. Me as a politician, me mama we born me, tell me. Say, he said, me pick an official go, we know. I say, what's up? He said, because you know one lie. Me mama we born me, honestly.
Right, definitely.
Because the reason is, Abraham, lie not good. When I say I do this, you know, one time I've been get a little emotional. I say I go sign any legal paper. 5 years, just one time of my governance. What I said to do if I not do them? May they can't give me injection. Lethal injection for kill me, I sign them. I remember them saying they, you know, they look me pain and say, oh my goodness, you know, when they get somebody, we get compassion like Kamarainba. Because so serious, why I went into politics? I don't left, I been work over $117,000 annual government job now. Why? Why I returned 4 years ago? Because I believe say me country dey pan go on a drain. It need a clear direction. It need somebody who fear God. It need for somebody who can tell the people the truth. Louis, for goodness sake, or us, Ibi, you build a mansion. Mm-hmm. All what you need in a one bedroom.
Right.
That bedroom day, what you need in a one bed. That bed day in a one side in a grave. All that 4-car garage, 10-car garage, swimming pool, all that is not, is vanity. What it more matter now that small side way later on? Why you want to live a good life? You picking the car of God. You they send them for me and can't study. You the way you seek. Look at the president recently. He they go Germany for checkup. But you go na Connaught, will not get MRI machine. Will not get even sober scan machine for do chest x-rays. Up to now, 1970s, 1980s scan machines that we get. You know, it's just so sad when you see country like that, where the president, they go abroad for medical checkup, but then, the make them this, I make I tell you this, a one honorable die. We will get a by-election where they come up now, na Tonkolili, na Bumbuna. The honorable, I talk to him, now he say, oh my God, he say, this hospital, you are church ram. He say, now four honorable don't go die this soon. He say, we need to call the church ram medical people, na parliament, logo interview them. Lo, we go see what they go on. Because now four, and I say, oh, because four honorable don't go die, you don't forget the thousands of Sierra Leoneans where they die, the hundreds of Sierra Leoneans where they die on a weekly basis, on that poor medical. Now because number four or three honorable don't die, now you want to send our church for go ask them. I say, when I left them happy there. Not so just because you be honorable, you special mother the other Sierra Leonean. We are all one. This blood where they flow now with body, now we all now the same, the organs are what we get. For goodness sake, when Lord put Sierra Leonean people in force. The honorable right. Set him out. He said, oh God, this is an APC honorable. He set him out. He said, oh my God. He said, Kamarainba. He said, well, I'm sorry. And I said, no. We don't forget this. Look at the medical thing. Because in a poor medical, sometimes this guy gets a slight hypertension, will not get a proper blood work. Let's just tell you one thing. Mm-hmm. Blood work for go check for viral load. When somebody get hepatitis B, one of me member, I call one thing. They say, pass and send the blood na South Africa or India. For go check in viral load for gear medication. Whoa. There is no blood work in a salon for go check within a viral load in a salon. Can you imagine? This now caught me on that. How can the nation wait for go check your blood, pass and send it to South Africa or India? Now then now after that, it will take weeks for come back before they give medication, before you don't die. It's, now then kind of states there, my brother, we really go for make sure the Sierra Leoneans them for think salon, for forget about region, forget about tribe, forget about party, for say I've died at this party, I've born at this party, just come for change once. Lord will try 5 years. Lord will see how I go move this country to a better height.
And so, Mr. Mansaray, the last question is, you know, we don't hear a rumor, you know, it is on newspapers for say, you not posting way ready for form a coalition with the SLPP in case they call on you. We go on for me, you rest that rumor today. If it is true, say it is true. Maybe during the runoff, I go form a coalition with them or I go merge with them or I would never. So what do you think about that rumor?
My brother, I said this over at last start. The day we Kamarainba or ADP, they join APC. Mm-hmm. May God make her not leave that day. The day where ADP or Kamarainba go join SFPP, may God not make her leave that day. You know, there's one thing where every human being forgets, and they call her integrity. Now, in lack, we can't talk with politics, we can't talk with leadership in that country. They not get no morals. Integrity come with you morals, no values, no tradition. When I say I want to run for this, I mean, I know they ever know my life. You know, some people that don't tell me say, oh, Kande Yumkela, if he lost, Mada B, if he lost, he can't join you. I mean, they can't join. But for say, you see, when you form a party, you go join them two political parties, form a coalition, you the party don't done. Now, in me don't make Temu Bongura Sobe done. You see PMDC, Charles Magai done. You see all the other party their way, we don't go form alliance with them, they don't. You know, they do them. If they can't join you, it's okay. Because they are already a traditional backbone, SFPP in 1951, for goodness sake, APC in 1961 or so. Mm-hmm. So when you want come, they can't join you, but you know, go join them. So now the problem is, we go embrace Because like I tell you, most of the people ain't go for camp, for but for say Mohamed Kamarainba Mansaray or the ADP go join SFPP, I go tell you outright say it not gonna ever happen. Because now one thing you see, one thing where I believe again are resilient. You forget resilient because it define resilient is defined with character. And also the character of any nation in the only judgment by the leaders. Because right now the character of Sierra Leone, the leaders they don't pull them. Now the character of Sierra Leone really for judged by the people.
Mm-hmm.
So the people them now they go for determine the fate of Sierra Leone come 2018. Because now don't the people of Sierra Leone now they don't define we the state of Sierra Leone for the past 55 years. So going forward, now I make a say all they say I believe in the Sierra Leonean people, and come 2018 the SFPP folks them we don't see a better vision. I don't think I no one call names there now. IB, I wish I for call names, but you're not gonna believe this. I get a lot of SFPP folks, including one of them where they run for flag bearer. We're ready for can join. Una go see how much time they go on. Wait when they don't get a flag bearer of SFPP and APC flag bearer. Now you go know how much some of them. But I gotta be careful because when one Mamina Losa during the election, he say Salon be the sit on a two pot. You know, Salon are like a pot, mm-hmm. not too far stone. So Salon are ever stable. Now so Salon be the go. He said, now you don't come, the third stone, now the pot don't can sit on, Salon don't sit on. He said, so that pot today, we ready for can make sure, say, this Salon don't sit on this time now. So folks them, I go for like I talk, say, but now there are other people where they can't join we, because when they can't join we, then go don't get with purpose, with manifesto, they know the vision, and they know, say, I'm a disciplined leader, and me not believe in tribal, I not believe in sentiment or friendship, I believe in Sierra Leone. Like I tell you earlier, say, I worship Sierra Leone, and I continue to make sure, say, Salon be a better country than the governance come 2018.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Mohamed Kamarainba Mansaray, a talk to you today from Maryland in the United States. Of course, now the presidential candidate for the Alliance Democratic Party, where now the new political party where they paralyze very rapidly now Sierra Leone. Of course, now Manda Wande will know for say it is stand up to the incumbent government at this point based on everything where you don't agree. And of course, we want to tell you, Mr. Kamarainba Mansaray, plenty, thank you for your time. And of course, anytime we'll call on you, you're always ready. We interviewed you last year by the radio, and of course, this time you don't camp out with TV. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, Brian. And I want to wish every Sierra Leonean a Merry Christmas, Happy New Year in advance. Everything whether they ask for, may God continue for guide them. May God continue for really make we country a better country. Thank you. I appreciate them. Like anytime you call on me, I go day back at this station. Thank you very much.
And we wish you a Merry Christmas as well. Thank you.